the highest ski resort in Central Asia.
This is unbelievably beautiful. You need to see this, what a nature, mountains, and the air. I can't describe this.
During that time, the cathedral was used as a stable. The mosque is over 100 years old and it was built with no nails at all. Can you imagine this? He was buried on the Issyk-Kul lakeside, not far from the city of Karakol.
Let's try.
Kyrgyzstan, 7 reasons to visit Karakol City. Hello, my friends! If any of you get the chance to visit Kyrgyzstan, consider visiting Karakol City, the administrative capital of the Issyk-Kul region. And in this video, I'm gonna talk about 7 reasons why you should visit the city, as well as a few things you can do and see while visiting. But before I start, let me tell you a little bit more about the city. The city of Karakol, formerly Przhevalsky, named after the Russian explorer Przhevalsky, is the 4th largest city in Kyrgyzstan. The city located near the eastern tip of the world's 2nd largest alpine lake, Issyk-Kul, about 150 km from the Kyrgyzstan-China border and 380 km from the capital city, Bishkek. The location of the city is a good base for all kinds of excursions into the beautiful surrounding area. And with this little introduction, let's start with my 7 main reasons why you should visit the city of Karakol. Reason number 1. Karakol is one of the Kyrgyzstan's major tourist destinations, serving as a starting point for the hiking, trekking, skiing, and mountaineering in the high central Tian Shan to the south and east. Also, this city is culturally rich with several different ethnic groups that live here, such as Dungan, Uyghur, Kalmyk, Uzbek, Russians, and of course, Kyrgyz. So, if you are a tourist, believe me, this city has a lot to offer. Reason number 2. Karakol has Central Asia's highest ski resort. With 20 kilometers of slopes situated about 20 minutes from the town. The riding at Karakol includes forest areas as well as cleared trails. Therefore, if you like skiing, winter will be the perfect time of the year for visiting the city. As for summer, you can go camping or hiking in the most stunning and picturesque places and valleys near the city, where you can visit the remote alpine villages of nomads and see how they live in such amazing mountain nature.
This is unbelievably beautiful. You need to see this, what a nature, mountains, and the air. I can't describe this.
Reason number 3. There is a Russian Orthodox Cathedral in the center of the city. And if you're looking for something spiritual, this place is always open for you. The cathedral was originally built of stone in 1872, when Karakol was a garrison town established as an outpost on the edges of the Tsarist Russian Empire. It was destroyed in 1890 by the earthquake and the current cathedral was built out of wood on a brick base. It took 6 years to complete and was finally completed in 1895. The history of the cathedral is very long and interesting. During an anti-Russian uprising in 1916, its monks were brutally murdered there. Over the years, particularly following the revolution in 1917, it has been used as an educational center, a ladies' gymnasium, a theater, a dance hall, and even as a coal store and stable. Then, in 1991, following the collapse of the Soviet Union and the independence of Kyrgyzstan, the local authority once again gave the building back to the church. Reason number 4. If you are a Muslim, I highly recommend you visiting the Dungan Mosque. The Issyk-Kul Central Mosque of Karakol City was built for the local Dungan community by the famous Beijing architect and 20 carvers with the skills of traditional Chinese architecture and composition techniques for building the mosque. Construction of the mosque began in 1904 and was completed in 1910. Ingenious techniques allowed the builders to build the mosque with no nails. The mosque holds 42 base pillars, and encircling the building is multi-tiered wooden cornice decorated with images of plants like grapes, pomegranates, pears, and peaches. From 1929 to 1947, during the Soviet era, the mosque was used as a storehouse. In 1947, the building was given to the Muslim community and continues to function as a mosque. It is registered as a historical monument and protected by law. Today the mosque is open to visitors.
There are so many visitors here. As you can see, the dress code is very strict here. Women must wear something that covers their heads and all other parts
of their body that are open. Reason number 5. If you want to learn more about the history of the city, the Memorial Museum of Przhevalsky will be a great place to do that. Nikolai Przhevalsky was one of the first Russian scientist geographer to start detailed studies of the geography, flora and fauna of the Central Asian countries. Beginning from 1870, he arranged 4 large expeditions to Mongolia, China and Tibet. During his expeditions, he revealed the exact directions of the mountain ranges and borders of the Tibet mountains. He described the nature, relief, climate, flora and fauna of the region in his works as the most beautiful he had ever seen. He died in the city in 1888 from typhoid fever on the eve of his 5th expedition to Central Asia. He was buried on the Issyk-Kul lakeside, not far from the city of Karakol.
Николай Михайлович Przhevalsky, первый исследователь природы Центральной Азии. Родился 31 марта 1839 года и умер 20 октября 1888 года.
Reason number 6. Local cuisine. I haven't tried this before, so this is my first time. Let's dig in. As the city has a long and unique history that has mingled so many cultures, there is also a wide variety of unique combinations of delicious food here. Without a doubt, I can say that only in this place you can immediately feel the amazing Asian culture of nomads, with its hospitable people, their yummy food, which can be mixed with spicy dishes of Chinese origin, prepared by the Dungan and Uyghur people. And if you are looking for something European, there are also lots of small and cozy cafes and restaurants with plenty of Russian or Ukrainian food. Last but not least, the prices for such delicious food are not very high here. For instance, a lunch for one will cost you no more than $5. And trust me, it will be very big and yummy.
Let's try.
Reason number 7. And I believe that this is the main attraction in the entire region, which is worth visiting in the first place. And of course, this is Issyk-Kul, the second largest mountain lake in the world. The best time of the year for visiting the lake is summer, and trust me, during this time, everyone finds their own interest here. You can go swimming, parachuting, snorkeling, and do many other water activities. Plus, you can go for all kinds of excursions to the most beautiful and picturesque places in the region.
Just look at this. Amazing.
Surrounded by a fascinating landscape of canyons, valleys, and high peaks, the lake shores also contain natural mineral sources, which can you visit all year long, no matter whether it's summer or winter. The water here is completely natural, coming from the depth of the earth, and contains all its beneficial mineral properties. Therefore, this is an ideal place to relax and get a healing effect on your body while traveling. With all that being said, I'm sure that you will definitely love this city in Kyrgyzstan and of course the entire Issyk-Kul region as well. Thanks for watching. I hope this video was helpful for you and your future travels. As always, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, leave your comments below and hit that like button as hard as you can. And I'll see you in the next video.